Hey, party peeps. Sorry, just get you plugged in. Springtime in Northern California is beautiful, green. We just came through the hills where I don't have a signal. I tried to Twitch it. I experimented with Twitch just because when I do my YouTube, I like to have my YouTube be 100% for sure. I hate buffering on YouTube, but I don't mind in Twitch, it's not as important. This is where my main audience is on YouTube, and I like to take care of my audience. You guys take care of me, I take care of you. So, what I want to say is, we've already knocked out two of the main roads I wanted to go on today, and we're going to go up, it's about an hour north of here, we're going to get to the third road, which we may lose our signal on, but we're going to have, at least join me for an hour on YouTube here, up to the point where we lose our signal. Say you're impressed. I gotta find something to eat too. I'm kind of hungry. But we'll make an extended field trip here. We're in no rush. We're just driving around today, enjoying. We gotta get back though. It's already 2:00. We're gonna get caught with heavy duty rush hour traffic going back to the valley. Let's go if we're gonna go. You guys ready? Let's say hi to everybody. Jared Rooks, Lodi girl, James. Great weather, I know. Let's go. I can't think of anything else. Without further ado, let's blast off. Mish, GR. I think, let's go this way. Turn around. Look at this. I want to make a U-turn illegally, and this guy's walking right in front of me. I knew that was going to happen. Ooh. Donuts. But I need something more significant than donuts. So the road we just came down off of is called Calaveras Road. And it kind of spans a couple of counties. It used to be a single lane wide, and now it's gotten a little bit wider over the decades. I discovered the road about 20 years ago plus, sometime in the mid-90s, maybe 25 years ago. And it's just a beautiful drive. Yeah, 1993 would have been when I found it. That's right. So that's 26 years ago I found that road. Wow. Time flies. And it used to be like a single lane road. You could squeeze two cars by each other, barely. But over the years, they've been, you know, keeping up with the paving of it. And, you know, they might go 2 inches a year. Now that's about just under exactly 2 lanes wide. So let's get back on the freeway here. Join me for the next hour or so. 78 degrees here. We're in the beginning of the end of spring. I'll say that the beginning of summer is coming here in Northern California, but it's still green, it's still pretty, and this is what I wanted to share with my peeps and the world, is how beautiful these three roads are. And these are just three roads that I know of. There's countless roads I don't even know of that if I had more time more money, I could go exploring up in those hills up to the right. Plenty of roads all around there, zigzagging around. Just beautiful. I just saw two riding stables. Well, no, I saw one riding trail rides, and the other one was just stables where you could board your horse, stuff like that. I went in there, but they don't have any trail rides. Although I did see a couple people riding on trails, but I think they probably own their horse and they were just out for riding their horse deal. I don't think they were paying a trail ride deal. Anyway, where was I going with that? Let's go. Let's just go down the road like we do. I'm happy today, man. Beautiful drive. I got some good footage. I'll put it up on YouTube, on my channel here, probably one video a month, so we don't overdose the channel on too much. You know, just keep it about once a month to be above, right? You know, like we do with our phone teeth is once a month. That's coming up this week, Friday. Like I said, I was disappointed in that video. It didn't come out great, but the message that the video conveys is the message I want to get out to my haters. And we really haven't had a significant problem with haters in the last few months. I think I scared them all away. Anyway, let's go. Fremont, California. Actually, you know, if we had time, you know what I should do? I don't have time, but we could go by the, if I knew where it was, too, I don't know where it is. But there's a Tesla, Tesla's around here somewhere, and they do public tours. We could go in there and do a vlog, filming how Tesla builds their cars. Wouldn't that be cool? Especially be cool. It wouldn't be cool now, but it'll be cool 50 to 75 to 100 years from now, when mankind is way different, and they can look back on stuff like that, vintage videos, some of the stuff we film and do. And I get a lot of criticism from truckers, like my back into a dark hole video. When you back into a dark hole, probably 30% of the comments are like, that was an easy back, that's no big deal. But what they fail to understand is that 50 to 75 to 100 to 1,000 to a million years from now, providing the video is still around, it will be significant to the people watching it at that time. It'd be like you and me watching the Egyptians building the pyramids on video. Wouldn't that be cool? You know, you can consider, you know, if somebody's out there, some Egyptian 4,000 years ago, filming them picking up and breaking up the big rocks and hauling them around and come up into a pyramid. What are you filming that for? This is what we do every day. It's boring. It's not boring to the future humanity. Think about it. I'm just saying, you guys are with me. We're making history right now. 4,000 years from now, people will be watching it. Look how green the hills are, man. I know that planet was even green at one time. Because maybe 4,000 years from now, the sky will be on fire. You know, like Terminator. Or, I'm sorry, Matrix. We think of the year as 1999, but it's closer to 2199. And this is like before the sky caught on fire. Anyway, so there you go. Scotty's deep thoughts for the day. Tesla dealer. There's a Tesla factory. You could do the factory tour. That's what I want to do. Is the camera bouncing too much? You guys let me know, because it's really getting, to me it looks like it bounces too much. Just scooch back a little bit. I don't like how it bounces. Yeah, I want to go to the factory and do the walk around tour. I don't know where it is. But we don't have time today. We might do it next time. Maybe in the summer, something like that, when it's all brown and ugly. Right now, we want to do we want to film the greenery of Northern California. The green and prettiness. So beautiful. Plus, I got to get something to eat. I think there's a Jack in the Box up here, maybe. Let's see what the sign says. Boulevard, Automall, Parkway. See, they don't have any food signs, man. Why don't they have any food signs? I'm not getting off unless I see a food sign for sure. Gas, food, you know, lodging, those signs, those blue signs. Oh, there's food right there. They didn't have a sign. You lost your business, boy. If they would have let me know there was food, I would have stopped right there. Fry's Electronics. Do mine. exit, but we'll keep our eyes peeled for food. Scotty hungry. Looks like a military vehicle, dude. No mud flaps. I'm gonna rat you up, boy. That's a major ticket. Put you out of service. Backing up on the other side of the K-Rail, people are panicking. Guy's backing up on the freeway, dude. He's on the other side of the protected concrete K-Rail. It's not even affecting us. Probably somebody looking at their phone and they looked up and saw the truck backing up, pickup truck, and they're like panicking. Oh my God. Station closed. Trucker made his move and jumped out. See that? Let's get over here. It's a downhill 6% grade. And these trucks are, to my opinion, they're going too fast. We'll see. Because I'm going 60 and I can't catch him on a 6% grade. Are you kidding me? And he jumped in front of that car hauler just to slam on his brakes. See that? Hang back a bit and look at this train wreck here. Let me jump in front of you. Personally, I would let you go in front of me. Be the one in front of me. go. Then I'll just go right around you when you wreck out. So I'm going 65, I can't even catch that truck. In California. Pass by like nothing. Let me pass you by because you're going too slow. There's 84. Let me think. Do I want to do that? Or if we go up 84, I might lose our signal. So let's just stay on the main freeways. Because I want to go up this other road over here. Come on, dude. I got to get away from this guy. He kisses that camera, he's going to be all over the top of me. Signal, so we'll just stay on the main freeway here. That's also a beautiful drive, but again, we'll do that some other day. Weeks and months to make videos all around Northern California to show you my Northern California. So many memories, so many beautiful things. There's another road up by Concord too. Oh, I forgot about that. Oh my God. Totally forgot about that. Goes to the hills. That would be a good one to film too. Right, you know, this time of year. April. It's the best time of year to be filming stuff around here. God, I forgot about that road, dude. Oh my Lord. So beautiful. small sign that tells you, but I don't see anything. I don't see anything for sure, so I'm not getting off. Safeway, though. They have, like, a deli. You can get a sandwich, I guess. But... yeah, I see nothing down there. Keep going. We'll find something. Taco Bell, I give him number one. It comes with a hard taco and a burrito supreme, hard taco supreme. So he made, most of it ended up on the ground. I said, eat it outside. We went to the park. I said, just get out of the car and eat it on the ground. Eat it outside so anything falls, it falls on the ground, birds will get it. Poor kid made a huge mess. The burrito got all over his thigh, the meat, but he was grubbing on it. Just doesn't understand the concept of seal up the bottom so it doesn't all squirt out the back end, the bottom end. No signal, but at least I could go up there and make videos and enjoy the view. I've never been there. I would love to go there. Oh my God. Jack London's one of my favorite authors, writers. From when I was a kid, that's when I really got interested in reading and storytelling. The guy was a great storyteller. And I kind of draw a lot of inspiration from my stories and how I present my videos from Jack London. Very simple. Start from the beginning, put the guts in it, and then go to the end and conclude it. And just make a story out of the video. Kind of like a book or a short story. I can't write a book or I can't write a story very well, but I can make a video. I'm pretty good at that. And my style and my personality says, you know, rough around the edges, and I can just do it like that, and it's accepted. It's just the way that it is. I love it. I love being, just be me. Do what I do. Okay, let's go see what we can find over here. I remember when they were building these bridges right here, these overpasses, this transition. So this is a much better transition than a clover leaf that they used to have in here. Jack and Bucks coming up in Livermore if we have to, but let's see what we can see. Lane ends. Do something, dude. There you go. Don't just sit right beside me and block me in. Santa Rita Road has some stuff because we used to. Our apprenticeship school used to be on Santa Rita Road up here. We used to go for lunch or go down there and eat. Definitely want to go eat and wash my hands before we try to attack this Mount Diablo Road. We'll get off here, that's fine. Scoot around all this traffic. I can't believe traffic's already backed up. It's only 2 in the afternoon. Dang, dude. many people in this state, man. What are you guys looking at? You go that way. Scotty shortcut. How do you like these light, what do you call it, the traffic light situation on these, on this intersection? It's like Stonehenge. You want to look this way. But it's so much more interesting to look that way. To me, it's like, it's futuristic, yeah, I guess, but it's also a huge amount of material that they spent to build it. I mean, I guess it's architecturally or aesthetically pleasing, but it is, man, a whole bunch of material. For what? Red Robin, what is that, a sit-down meal? They cook robins in there? Those little birds with the red chest? Red robin, dude. It seems like you'd have to kill a whole bunch of them to make a little bit of meat. Five Guys. I've never been to Five Guys. I've heard it's good. You guys want to try Five Guys with me for the first time? Might get it like a cheeseburger or something. Drink. I want to go to Red Robin. Oh, I forgot to bring my little portable charger. Can't do a sit-down meal. I forgot that little charger. I left it in the truck. Los Positos. I don't know which way to go, dude. Painting your toenails. Oh my god. Too funny. This should spit out on Santa Rita Road up here. That used to be like a little shortcut I would take to get around the bad traffic. Just so I could get back into the bad traffic. Yeah, Santa Rita Road. Right here. It would be, it'd give you a little bit of relief, but not much. Then there was this chick that lived down there. Not a girlfriend, I just remember she lived down there, I'll say that. Fried eggs, I don't like fried eggs, see, I like, scrambled eggs or an omelet, but I can't really do fried eggs because it's still kind of, the egg, the yolk is still runny, like it's still alive. I can't eat a runny yolk, never could. And the egg whites on a fried egg are, they're white, dude. They're not yellow. And it's gross. I like my egg to look yellow when it's all done and done. Like scrambled eggs are yellow, you know what I mean? Or an omelet is yellow. But fried eggs are like white around the edge and then like a runny, still alive, squirmy egg yolk. And it's kind of gross. I'm like, yuck. Five Guys was. Is it on the left? Oh, everything that's going to be on somewhere is over here on the left. Let's see if it is. Can't make a left or I already missed it. Turn. Baskin Robbins. Taqueria. Panda Express, Taco Bell. Anything else? see anything else. Burger. There's a burger place. I think I want to go in there. Starbucks. Let's go be nosy. Can we make this? Oh, probably can't make a U-turn, huh? What is that, dude? Fantastic Sam's, what's that? Shoot. Nothing I could do. I can't. I'd rather go to the right, because that's. Yeah, I know. I was going to go over there. No U-turn. Can't do it. So I got to get over here. Skip it. I'm all burnt now. Motorcycle bah honked at me. McDonald's! Could have gone there too. I got all discombobulated. There's too many people in this state, man. It makes me nervous. Jack in the Box up here at Vasco. We'll do that. We have to go in and wash our hands anyway. So, pocket time, because I can't wash my hands in the sink holding the phone. No, we're gonna go up to Mount Diablo today. Now we're probably going to lose our signal up this hill, but that's okay. I just wanted to talk to my peeps and keep connected with you guys for a bit. We'll stay connected as long as we can, after which I will just make standard videos on, you know what I mean, with the camera, phone, video, and the mount, and film going up the road to Mount Diablo and look at the beautiful views. And then over the next several months, I'll drop snippets of the video, you know, cut of this, cut of that. One video a month or something. It depends on how popular they are. And I can drop them into a new playlist, probably going to be tentatively titled Springtime Forever. Will be the playlist title. Pretty soon, if not already, and then we'll get back there and Kennedy's got him though. I gotta talk to Kennedy anyway and see if she needs help getting a driver's license. I'd like to get her a license, and she can use this car right here, and I can help with Carl's Jr. Okay, I don't care for Carl's Jr. as much as Hardee's. It's way better. you're stuck behind somebody going so slow. Either somebody's running me over and beeping at me, or I'm running over somebody else. There can be no happy medium in my life. It's always got to be like this. Chaos. Just ran over something. Great. Flat tire in a couple days. Brilliant. That's what you get for letting your anger take over. I was a little bit angry, but not too bad, but I used to be raging. So I went to anger management. But you can see what happens. A little bit of anger acts like karma in your life. It screws you up. So, you know, when I say the guy was going kind of slow, probably would have been better off to hang out behind him, because now you never know what you did to the space-time continuum by changing where you should have been in the scheme of things, behind the slower vehicle instead of speeding out in front of him. See what I mean? You changed the future. Days they never had numbers on the exits. It's only been around for about 10 years, more or less, maybe less. So California was like one of the last states to add numbers to their exits, and they finally got around to doing it. Oh, it's probably a good idea. Let's put numbers. Big Five, never mind. I saw the five and I got excited. It's Big Five Sporting Goods, not Five Guys Burgers. You know what? I think we have to go back east to get to, Yeah, that's okay though. I drove right by it so many times I didn't even think to. Vasco Road North is also interesting. I don't even know. I'm not sure you can get through all the way to Antioch or Brentwood on Vasco Road North anymore. I had heard that they filled up the valley with a big water reservoir where that road used to go. I don't know. I'm going to have to go exploring over there. Maybe I can Google map it. Fat Burger. I never did Fat Burger. Which side is Fat Burger over here? I have never seen a Fat Burger. Let's go over here. Let's be nosy. It must be over there. I've never seen a Fat Burger over there. If I had, I would have tried it. It must be on the north side. So it's on the north side. One block past McDonald's is over here. Okay, let's try that. Fat Burger is mentioned in the song by Ice Cube. It was a good day. I didn't have to use my AK. It was a pretty good day. I didn't have to use my AK. I think that's the song. talks about the fat burger. Must be down here. Is it on the other side of the road? Probably. My luck. Wiener Schnitzel. AM, PM. Quick stop. Toyota. There's no fat burger over here. Is it one block? Wait. A&W. A&W burger? Is that it? Let's go over here. Maybe one more. Turn into which? Quick Stop right here? Turn into Quick Stop, he says. Wait a minute, guide me in. I don't know what to do. Behind Chevron, he said. I got a visual. There's Fatburger right there. Can't get through. There's a concrete barrier. See that? Can we get through over there? No. Can we get through? Authorized vehicles only. Concrete, dude! Oh, smooth. It gets over here. Oh, okay, there it is. Fat Burger. Found it. Turkey Hill in Pennsylvania. Go over the concrete. Dukes of Hazzard. Let's take both phones in a case. They have music. We can still chat while we're waiting for the burger. Agreed? I got these new trousers. You guys remember buying them with me at Sportsman's Outdoor Store, whatever that place is called. Check them out. Check out my trousers. See them? These are the ones. The only thing I kind of don't like is that the phone is on the right side, kind of high on the hip. So when you try to sit down, it tries to bend the phone in half. But they're pretty good. They got this hook right here. What is this all about? And are you guys still there? Did I lose you? Sorry. Pushed the wrong button. I was gonna say this hook right here, what is this all about? That? What is that? Right, pocket time. Put the camera down and twirl. I hear a faint music. Let's make our order and then, mute. I give up. This is way too much. The guy ahead of us, talking to his chick, trying to get her order and his order, and it's, get the whole order is like 15, 16 bucks, whatever it was. And he tries to pay for it with a card, and they're like, let me see your ID. And he goes, well, it's my wife's card. Because I can't do anything. It's got to be your card and your name. It's got to match your ID. I can't do anything. And they're going back and forth arguing about, but we're married. So now they have to go over to the gasoline side cashier, pull some cash off the debit. He goes, is it a debit card? Yeah, a debit card. So they're trying to pull cash off of it, and it won't work because it's an American Express. Or some kind of problem, and I'm like, I'm not even gonna play. Let's go somewhere else. I'm done. I am done. I can't have all this crap happening to me at the same time. People walking across my path when I'm ready to go, or driving across my path, or ordering a burger in front of me and they ain't got no money to do it. Can't handle it, dude. I can only handle so much. Scotty's at his limit, about right up here. Can only take about that much more. And I'm just go somewhere else. I'm done. Oh, no left turn out of here. This is why I don't like this kind of places, because you can only go, there's only one choice to get out of here. Look at this. Watch, what do you want to bet? So it says right turn only because there's a concrete and there's 1,000 cars coming. What do you want to bet? There's no U-turn. Yep, exactly right. No left, no U-turn. So we got to go down 12 miles to turn around somewhere, and we're not even eating, and we're losing our blood sugars, dropping like a rock right now, and we're getting mad. See what I mean? Tofu burger. Snickers. Come on! Why is there 52,000 cars coming right now? Right when I'm ready to go, that light could have been red back there, but oh no, 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 no. Here comes Scotty, let's turn green and dump a whole bunch of traffic in front of him. Fate and destiny. Right, one more car. Two more, three more, four more, come on! Go over one lane maybe. Help a brother out, now I got a red light, brilliant. Oh my Lord. I had to wait for that one car, now we got a red light. How do you like me now? Let's just go down here. I got an idea. You're entering private property. No trespassing. Let me get a ticket down here too. Can we get out this way or is it circle around? Got to hit 52,000 speed bumps. That's okay, we're just gonna do this real quick. Just kinda got game. Of course, there's a car behind me. Every time, dude. And we'll have to sit here for an inordinate amount of time at this red light. You watch this. This red light will be 10 minutes. Start timing it. Well, while we're waiting, let's look at this brochure. You guys ready? Is this thing in the way? I stopped here to go trail riding. They had a sign out front. Sign out front! Trail riding! So I stop in there. I go, I want to ride a horse today. What do I got? You got to call this number on the back of this brochure and set it up. I go, set up what? You guys got your sign out right now. But they got a whole brochure and trail riding and horseback and all this kind of thing. And I wanted to do it. Why would you put a sign out in front of your business and then tell somebody, oh no, just ignore that sign. That sign doesn't mean anything. I'm like, dude, I want to get on the horse. Wiener schnitzel. No. I don't really like hot dogs that are full of meat, that stuff that fell on the floor in the butcher place. Body parts of the animal that they can't sell. We recommend not using a GPS for directions, as they frequently inaccurate about our location. I'm reading the, I'm sorry, I was reading the thing on the brochure. Writing lessons. I don't need a lesson, I just need a chair ride. 1 hour Western group lesson, $45. How many in there? Is it per person? Probably. Horse camp. Ooh, horse camp. That's for kids. Join us for winter, spring, summer day camp, age 6 and up. Kids learn all about the horses. Nathan could not do that. Birthday party, safety, quality experience. No, I don't think. Trail rides, here we go. Look, I left here. We should go to the next light, probably. 20 minutes on a kid's pony, $15. Of course, I'm too big for a kid's pony. So we got different rides here. The most expensive one is a... Well, no, they got a 5-hour ride. No, they got a half-day ride. 5-hour ride, Monument Trail. That looks like fun. That'd be a long way. I don't know if I could do 5 hours, dude. 2-hour ride, 2-hour ride, 1.5-hour ride, 1.5-hour ride, $60 for an hour and a half. 1-hour ride, $45. Half-hour ride, $30. That's not too bad, dude. That isn't bad at all. I just wanted to get on the horse and get my GoPro going, dude. They're gonna make me wear one of those stupid helmets, though? That's my question. You gotta wear the helmet. Well, I can't fit my stupid GoPro on there. That's the whole point, make a video. Yeah, can I get a sourdough jack and a large iced tea? Nah, that's it.
Jordan, looks like on the street.
Yeah, I think so. Well, it's kind of a good thing. It's kind of a good thing I didn't do that ride today, because I forgot to bring my battery pack. I could probably do like an hour ride with the battery, but I mean without the battery, but pretty close to it. But it would be nice to have the battery backup. The battery pack thing. While you're riding the horse, they could plug things in. Mish didn't like the Taco Bell. Well, it's fast food and it's designed, you know, Taco Bell isn't really... It's all gringoized. It's not high quality. What are they looking at? These chicks are looking at me, dude. What are those chicks looking at? Dang, dude. Anyway, Taco Bell, Jack in the Box. Ziggy knows what I wanted. When, then what part is not fluffy? He is on Vasco Road, yes. We and Scotty are fast food? Hell no. If I were to eat a home a home cooked good quality meal would make me puke. Would make my butt puke. Because my body would not be able to would not be able to handle it. Too funny. Oh my god, too funny. Gotta stay pretty. Thank you, babe. So, 5 o'clock shadow at 4:53. We're getting our shaving video, woo! Too funny. Let's go. I think I have to go back east to pick up the Don Diablo road we want to get on, right? East. I meant to charge up my GoPro before we left. Tesla? Hit me, dude. Every time I try to change lanes, somebody's right there in my way. Alright, so I haven't been up here only one time in my life, and it was North Livermore exit, going north. I was explaining earlier, my buddy and I drove up, but he goes, oh, no, let's go up to Mount Diablo. I'm we're sitting around smoking weed, and he goes, let's go up the hill, dude. You ever been up there? I'm like, no. He said, let's go. And we drove up there, and the road turned into one lane. Stupid! Ran over that tire. That's a good capture right there. Anyway, looking at your phone, that's why they didn't... They could have avoided it if they were paying attention. Maybe. Anyway, so my buddy and I were smoking weed. Let's go up to Mount Diablo. I've been up there. I'm like, no. Because let's go, man. Let's take the dog. And we got all the way up there. We're smoking weed on the way up there, just getting high, high, high. And he let the dog out. And the dog was running in front of the pickup truck because we're going up the hill. And that's all I remember. We were stoned out of our minds driving up that hill. Now, I don't know how long we're going to keep our signal, but if we do lose our signal, you can rest assured what I will do. Look at this sports car in front of us. That looks like I'm trying to see what it is. Is it an Audi? That's an Audi A8, isn't it? Is that an Audi? That's one of those fancy cars, dude. Anyway, so I don't think I've ever seen one in the flesh. Cool. Anyway, so I will film it on standard video, and then I'll drop the video next month or whatever. The guy was, drove me up here. He had two girlfriends going at the same time. And one of them lived up here on a, like a ranch. And the other one was, I don't want to say too much. But he had both chicks going at the same time. What am I supposed to do, man? I love them both. Each one has qualities that I wish they both had. Like, if I could take half the qualities of this one, and half the qualities of that one and make one girl, I'd be in bliss. And I was like, dude. Oh, look at the cows. Looks like it has a bloody nose, dude. What you been scraping your nose on, girl? I don't know. They are so inconvenienced. You made me stand up, I'm mad now. Sorry, I didn't, you didn't have to get up. As you were, cows. All right, let's go. Oh shoot, I think we're stuck. I made it. Let's go. Look at the baby calves. Wish I had an air horn right now, boy. Look at these cows. Look at the pretty cows. Pretty cows. Sitting along the fence. Let the cars go. Go, cars. They're so happy. Look at that tall green grass they're chewing on. They love it. Let's go. You guys ready? We saw the cows. about it. Let me, where's that charger? Charge up the GoPro while we're thinking about it, because we're going to forget. Wait, what? What is this? What that piece of crap? Oh, yes. Yeah, we're okay. Panic. Come on! Oh, I know what's wrong. GoPro has to do everything backwards. Everything's wrong with GoPro. They're kind of like the Tesla of the camera world. We do it our way. We do stuff our way and you have to live with it. Oh my God, really? Can't do this. Let me get over. Dodge. Stupid GoPro plug. Plug it in. And let's go. Look at these pretty green hills. I love it. Mount Diablo is about I gotta look it up on Wikipedia. I thought it was like 2,000 foot tall mountain. Like Ireland, the Emerald Isle. 43 miles an hour and a 15 mile an hour curve, boy. Wherever that Audi went, it's probably already gone, done. Where it needed to go already so fast. Right? Crossing the narrow bridge at the same time. Brilliant. We made it. Water down there too, dude. That's why these people settled here 150 years ago, because there's water. Oregon Territory Road, that's it. Is this the road we should go on? Let's try this road here, dude. Man, that was a big old bull right there, boy. This is the road, dude. Pretty sure. Bicyclist. I don't want to scare him, so we'll just ease up on him here. Again, we're going to lose our signal anytime. If we don't, it'll be a miracle. Love to live back up in here, boy. Not too far from my fast food. And far enough away from the city to be in the country, you know what I mean? .3 feet. So this is where it begins, the one-lane road. You see that, right? These are my favorite roads in Northern California, the one-lane roads and the hilly, green, pretty. pretty drive. Love it, man. Might even see some wildlife. Look at the beauty of this place. People live back up in here, boy. Oh my God, so beautiful. It's a different, a whole different memory. I don't remember being like this when I was high on dope. Smoking weed. This is absolutely beautiful, dude. I love it. There's some wild turkeys right there. Hang on a second. Oh, I can't do it. Can't risk getting stuck on that edge. But there's some wild turkeys right there. I was gonna take a video of them, but there's traffic all over me. Dang, dude. Barely fit through here. A couple of wild turkeys, you missed it. No place to pull over to look at stuff, man. I probably could have if I had like a four-wheel drive pick-em-up truck. Look at these, man. All right, is everybody still here? Sorry. we're climbing out of the bottom. It should be... Let's see. You got to see this before we go. Are we back? Before we go... Windy. Just take it in. It's kind of windy up here. I'm losing my hat. Oh my God, so beautiful. So we came from way down there in the Livermore. Stunning, exactly right. I can't think of a better word. Spectacular, no. Breathtaking, maybe. Stunning, yes, agreed. And a single lane road. Look at this. The road is barely wide enough to get two cars by. Look at this. We're over there. We're off the road a little bit. But you can see there's barely enough room right here for another car to get by. And there's a California poppies again. Very small car. Look at this. Oh, goodness gracious. This is what I'm talking about, party peeps. Didn't I say over the last 3 years on my channel, if people have been following me, I said I wanted to come up here and make a video of this stuff. I wanted to do it 20 years ago. I've been wanting to do it for years, but who could I show it to? Who could I show that to? I took my hood off, dude. Let's go. But who could I show it to before YouTube existed? I was like, it won't do any good to film it. It's just for me. And I never thought to, I never had the forethought to sit there and take my 8mm camera in the 90s that I had. I bought one in 95 or so. One of those little palm quarters. You put it, strap around your hand. And it was about the size of, called a palm quarter. An RCA 8mm cassette tape you popped in the side and it had a battery and you hit the record button and you record stuff like this. And I thought, Nobody's, I'll film it, but who's gonna watch it? Nobody will watch that. It's crazy. Now I think to myself, all these years later, damn, I wish I would have recorded more, because I have a way to digitize it now. Put it on DVDs, also put it on YouTube. Let's go. We're probably gonna lose our signal again, but what are you gonna do? We try our best. Wait a minute, let me go back to, it's a small car. This one, northeast of Sacramento, you've talked about? Northeast of Sacramento. Yeah, I'm trying to remember which. That you're live from a place like that. We can camp in a single lane in the road in the mountains every year here, and it's dead to the world. Yeah. You know, I don't know. Let's go. But yeah, I appreciate sharing this with you guys. I love, this is one of my favorite things. It's very simple. That's what is exciting to you, Scotty. You're a very simple man. Trust me, this is one of the most, this is one of the things, this is like ice cream to me. This is like one of those pleasures in life. To drive through here at this time of year, because it's so rare to see this greenery in California, it is something very special. I cannot convey that enough to anyone in the world, how beautiful this is. And to share it with somebody. And to preserve it on film on my channel, and I can come back when I'm 95 years old. Lord help me if I live that long. I can watch the video again. Again and again and again. And enjoy it all over again. That's what I'm talking about. Can't even begin to do justice from a camera pointing straight ahead. You gotta live to drive. You gotta drive this yourself, in other words. So you can look out the side windows and see what I see. In fact, let me check this GoPro, how much battery's on it, because I might, if I could put the camera on my head and show you what the driver sees, you'll be stunned. Phasers on stun. Okay, we got 77% on the GoPro. Give it a few more minutes. What I'll probably do is turn around and go back down the hill and GoPro that on the descent. But we're climbing right now. I think it's another 50 miles to Mount Diablo. This thing said 25-mile-an-hour limit for the next 58 miles, and that was like a couple miles ago. So we'll see. God, it's so windy. Hang on. These winds, that's what dries out all this grass, the wind. It's unfortunate. It's gonna rain and snow this year, so that's why everything is so freaking green and pretty now. Beautiful. There's a property for sale right there. How many acres? It doesn't say, it just says for sale. You know, I fantasize about if I were a multimillionaire, what I would do is buy a property up here, like 1,000 acres, and buy a property in Southwest Washington where there's plenty of water, and buy myself a couple of 5,000 gallon tanker trucks, and just have hire drivers to bring water down. Bring water down from my property up there and run sprinkler system on, and keep my stuff green all year round. That's what I would do. It'd be worth it. 10,000 gallons of water per week, running through the sprinklers, and keep my property green, boa, all year. Didn't I tell you? Bunch of turkey times. Are we still, do we still have a signal? We lost our signal for a moment. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. There was this security. Every time it does a security check, we get kicked off. It's starting to piss me off. Somehow, the phone asked me a couple weeks ago, whatever the timeline was, would you like us to do having security on your feed? And I was like, yeah, sure. And ever since I've done that, it kicks me off, kicks us off. So let's get out and be nosy. Oh my God, I can't get out of this little bitty car, dude. Like I said, it's just beautiful up here. Sleep on a roost, yeah. And they can fly to save themselves. Oh my God, it's so beautiful up here. I love it. It's nice and cool up here, like 60 degrees, 65-ish. Oh, look at that little, guy. You want some of that green grass? Ooh, yummy. See, they ate all their grass down to nothing. They love this tall grass. Oops. Don't bite my fingers. Put it in the palm of my hand like this. Don't bite me. This little one wants one too. He wants a handful. They like the green grass. Racing horses, yeah. Look how short they are compared to me. It's a little bitty guy. You're so small and short. They're very friendly, let me pet them. You see their winter fur? They need a haircut or brushing or something. They just like the green grass. We like the green grass. Green grass is fine. Let's drop it over here. Oh, yeah, we lost our signal again. This is beautiful. You guys got to see this. Could you imagine living up here? Probably gonna, the further away from town, we're probably gonna lose our signal.